Good afternoon. As St. Paul opened his letters, so let us open today's service. So greetings and salutations to all who have gathered with us for this virtual commissioning service for Marcy Menard to the task of spiritual direction to the office of spiritual director of Elm Street Congregational Church in the Central Massachusetts Association of the Southern New England Conference of the United Church of Christ. Welcome, everyone.
Good afternoon. Join me in our call to worship. God's love is on the loose, wild and free. And the church is called to follow. As people of Christ, we gather here today to affirm God's call here and now in this place with Marcy. God's call sometimes comes in nice, neat packages that make perfect sense. God's call sometimes comes in wild, crazy, and wondrous packages that seem out of place. God's call sometimes comes from the church and other times from outside. The call of God to follow Christ is odd and wondrous, familiar and confusing, fulfilling and challenging. God says, "Whom shall I send?" And today we affirm Marcy's refrain, "Here I am, send me." Will you pray with me? God of grace and compassion, we give you thanks. We gather this day in joy and celebration. We love Marcy so much. We celebrate her faith, her leadership, her commitment, her laughter, her adventurous spirit, her stubborn commitment. We admire how she stands firm in a rushing river, yet has such an open, listening heart. We envy the close relationship she has with you and seek her prophetic, healing voice to lead us. Our world is confusing and fractured with hurt and sorrow, and we give you thanks that Marcy is called to a ministry of hope and healing. Today, we give thanks and affirm your call, but we also recognize that we must pledge to accept the responsibility of doing ministry with Marcy, that we will call on the wider church to recognize this ministry. We are called to love and support Marcy. As we come together in covenant, sealing together our commitments to be the body of Christ, let us accept the challenges and the joy of ministry. Let us cherish the love of Marcy, but also hold her and ourselves accountable. We ask the Holy Spirit to blow in on our celebration, stirring our hearts and minds, connecting us between spaces. We come to catch the Holy Spirit throwing smiles at our faces. We come to dance, to sing, to call out to God that love is our law. Our opening hymn is "How Great Thou Art."
Thank you.
Our virtual offering will be taken today to benefit the Central Mass Association Scholarship Fund. Contributions can be sent through Venmo, searching for the Central Mass SNEUCC. Please insert a note saying for commissioning of Marcy Menard. Checks can also be made out directly to the association and mailed to the Central Mass Association, 6 Institute Road, Box 5, Worcester, Mass., 01609. And thank you for your offering. And please join with me for the Thanksgiving for Offering response. Gracious God, thank you for the gifts received today. Take them and use them to fulfill your purpose for those seeking ministry. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our call to confession. Let us confess our sins to the Lord. God of all mercy, we confess before you and one another that we have been unfaithful to you. We waste opportunities to do good, and we look the other way when you cry out to us in the suffering of our brothers and sisters in need. We look to you for forgiveness of anything that separates us from you, for those that we commit deliberately and those that we allow to overtake us. We pray for strength and guidance to follow in your ways and love all of your people with the perfect love that you have shown us. In the name of our risen Christ, amen.
Siblings in Christ, be assured in your heart that you are forgiven. Amen.
Let us listen to our scripture reading for the day. This is from Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 4, beginning with verse 1. I, therefore, the prisoner in the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to the one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. But each of us was given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore, it is said, when he ascended on high, he made captivity itself a captive. He gave gifts to his people. When it says he ascended, what does it mean but that he had also descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who descended is the same one who ascended far above all the heavens so that he might fill all things. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure of the full stature of Christ. Here ends the reading.
Greetings again, my siblings in Christ. Today, you will bear witness to the official church rite that will allow Marcy to practice spiritual direction as a commissioned member of the Central Association of the Southern New England Conference of the United Church of Christ. Spiritual directors like pastors and chaplains are equipped to equip the saints for work of the ministry in a way that is set apart from other forms of ministry. I think this is probably because these ministries require a great deal of personal dedication to Christ. They require special training and knowledge, and they carry great amounts of responsibility. It is both a joy and a responsibility to equip others for discipleship in Christ. Now, Marcy's journey that has led to today has been many years in the making. She, like many of us, hasn't received just one call and voila, she's a spiritual director, but instead God called her in increments. Each time God asked her to take on a greater role, she just kept saying yes. Maybe not right away, but every time God asked her to move forward in ministry, eventually she did. And I would like to share how God has been leading and equipping her since she was in our Sunday school many years ago. I'm not going to say how many. And maybe through her story, you might hear God calling you. Over the years that I have been pastoring Elm Street, Marcy has shared bits and pieces of her story with me, and I have permission to share some of them with you. Marcy's call story began in early childhood when she had an innate understanding that God was real and that somehow God was calling to her to a deeper connection, a relationship, dare I say it, a ministry, even though she probably would not have been able to articulate that at the time. The Bible gives us examples of children being called to service, like Samuel and Eli. You know, Samuel was Hannah's son, and she dedicated him to the temple, and he went to the temple to live with Eli. And one night when Samuel was a little boy, he heard someone calling to him and calling Samuel, 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 and he would get up and go to Eli to see what Eli wanted. And Eli's telling him, I'm not calling you, just go back to bed. And he did it again. And he said, I'm not calling you, go back to bed. And then he thought, you know what? I must be God calling Samuel. So he said to Samuel, he said, the next time you hear that someone's calling you, say, speak for your servant is listening. And of course he did. And the person that was calling him was God. And Samuel then spent a lifetime in the service of God. Most of us do not hear a clear call in the middle of the night or have a high priest for a mentor. Most of us get inklings. We start to wonder about God in a way that most of our peers do not. We start to think about God working in our lives and around the world and around us. And at some point, we step onto a different path. Now, Marcy said in youth group and youth events played a big part in her development of her faith. It was on a trip to Mount Menandok, a Christian camp, where she made a commitment to stand for Jesus, and she found out how rare that really was. She said the counselors gathered all the campers together in a big group, and they asked them to close their eyes, and they asked them a question that who would stand for Jesus. And Marcy felt a pull, a desire to stand. So she stood up for Jesus. And of course she had her eyes closed and she didn't know who around her was standing up. And then the counselors said, okay, you can open your eyes. And when she did, there were only maybe four or five other campers in the room that had stood up. So they had them sign their name on a poster and they put it on the wall. And Marcy said when she went back many years later, there was her name on the poster still on that wall. Life happens. You get a job, you get married, you have children, you go to school, you work, you buy a house, you have a mortgage, and still there is a call in the back of your head. And Marcy had many different roles at Elm Street. God simply would not let her alone. She taught Sunday school and worked with the youth group and adult education, and was part of the intercessory prayer group, the evangelism team, was a deacon, a member of Christian education and worship committees, was on the leadership board, and was even the church moderator. She also covered the church between the time Pastor Chris was called away and the time that I was called here. She often turned to her pastors, Pastor Pat and Pastor Chris, who supported her and helped her to discern what God was calling her to do. Her faith in God continued to grow, and by the time I arrived, she was enrolled in spiritual direction program at the Spiritual Life Center in Connecticut. She completed her coursework and graduated in 2018 and was subsequently asked to sit on the Spiritual Life Center's board of directors. And she is involved in a spiritual director community of practice. While still in the process of discernment, Marcy had learned about the UCC, had to learn about the UCC and its theology, which is not quite as easy as it sounds. Because we are a denomination made up of a lot of different denominations, that we have at least four main theories of atonement or understandings of how the world works, which I will not bore you with now. But Marcy had to do some coursework, and that was my contribution to helping her get through this process. Now, Marcy has provided Elm Street with many opportunities to invigorate our spiritual selves by providing small group exercises after worship on Sundays before COVID. And during COVID, she provided virtual meditation classes on Facebook that helped us through our Lenten journey this year, as well as participated in Llewellyn's Lenten conversations from her unique vantage point of spiritual direction. Marcy has also worked with other congregations' consistories, helping them build interpersonal relationships through the lens of spirituality, and has gotten rave reviews. Marcy's journey has not always been easy. She has not always gotten all the support or recognition that she should have, and yet she never gave up. She kept her trust in God to bring her through. Now, Marcy says that she felt like God was calling her to become a spiritual direction minister to help others in the ministry have a deeper understanding of their own spirituality so that they may encourage their flocks to understand Christianity as a spiritual endeavor. And by using spiritual direction tools, help guide congregations when they must make difficult decisions or have difficult conversations. She also feels that there's an interfaith component to her work, but she hasn't figured out how that's going to work out yet. God continues to throw new things her way. She became a chaplain for Compassus Hospice out of Auburn. Now, this was really a strange way that this happened. She was a hospice aide, all right? She went and visited people who were dying. And they needed a chaplain. And she applied, but she wasn't commissioned yet, and they didn't feel that she had the right credentials. So they said, you know, not at this time. Well, 6 months or so later, they advertised the position again, and this time they hired her. And she was a per diem chaplain, now working with the very patients that she had cared for in a very physical way. She was now caring for them in a very spiritual way. And a year and a half later, she becomes the full-time head chaplain of the hospice center. Wow, who could have ever seen that coming? Who would have ever thought that that's where God would be leading her? I don't think God's done with Marcy. I really don't. I have no idea what his plans are, but I'm pretty sure they're spectacular because he is always leading her somewhere new. He's always equipping her to do ministry in a new way. And he's always showing us through her how our discipleship, mine and yours, can grow if we just listen for the Spirit. So today, we are celebrating the wonderful work that God is doing through Marcy and through our church. So so that together we can be more equipped to make disciples of Christ, teaching the commandments that Jesus taught us, and baptizing in the name of the Creator, the Redeemer, and Sustainer. Marcy, God will continue to bless you and our congregation and the wider church through you. You are a precious gift.
Wow. Okay. So following along with Pastor Kathy's message today, I will be reading an intercessory prayer this afternoon, and it has been written by Marcy, and you can pray along with me. A prayer for justice. O Holy One, may justice flow like a river, reaching our barren lands and sun-scorched deserts. May we care for the beautiful creation of Mother Earth that you have given us as a place to tend as a home. Be with all those that feel forgotten and hopeless. Let your life-giving water comfort them. Where children lie abandoned or abused, shield and protect them, O Lord. For the children who have been separated from their families, hear our cries for reunion. Where communities suffer at the hands of prejudice, non-acceptance, and unwelcome, let there be love. Where there is a racial prejudice, hate crimes, false imprisonment, and murder, hear our prayer, our cries for justice. Where there is religious intolerance, help us to know we are all children of God, created and loved equally by you. Grant us the power in your holy name to work together toward building bridges and breaking down walls, so that together we can work towards a more just peace. For the abusive powers of the world, let them hear your might and calls for unity under your banner of love, justice, and peace. Guide them in their decisions and actions. Help us to be more educated, wise, and aware of the suffering among your children in the world. Help us to study our history and work towards breaking down the corrupted systems that are in our history and in our present time. Let the breath of your Holy Spirit guide us on the paths of Jesus to bring equity to the marginalized, clothe the naked, feed the hungry, and help heal the human soul. Lead us onward towards love of neighbor, showing a radical, life-giving love as you have loved us. Tend to our weary hearts, O Lord, as we continue to love and serve you with a greater understanding of the many cries for justice. Grant us peace, unity, and love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now please join me in the Lord's Prayer using debt and debtors. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. We have some special music for this service. It is being presented by Barbara Lammert, a friend to all at Elm Street Church. The song is Lamb of God.
Son, no sin to hide, but you have sent him from your side to walk upon this guilty sod and to become the Lamb of God. A gift of love they crucified. They laughed and scorned him as he died. The humble king they named a fraud and sacrificed the Lamb of God. Oh, Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love the holy Lamb of God. Oh, wash me in his precious blood, my Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. So lost I should have died, but you have brought me to your side to be led by your staff and rod and to be called a Lamb of God. Oh, Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love the holy Lamb of God. Oh, wash me in his precious blood, my Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God.
Grace and peace to you. The Central Massachusetts Association of the Southern New England Conference of the United Church of Christ greets you in the name of Jesus Christ, the head of the church who calls all of us to the ministry of reconciliation. Hear these words from the Apostle Paul. My sisters and brothers, I want you to know the truth about the gifts of the Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit gives them.
There are different ways of serving, but the same God is served.
There are different abilities to perform service, but the same God gives ability to each of us for our particular service.
The Spirit's presence is shown in some way in each person for the good of all.
Friend in Christ, Elm Street Congregational Church, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, has called Marcy Menard to serve as our spiritual direction minister. and respectfully request that the Central Mass Association commission for her for this ministry according to the faith and order of the United Church of Christ.
The Central Massachusetts Association has reviewed the request of Elm Street Congregational Church. We have prayerfully examined Marcy concerning her fitness for this ministry and are pleased to commission her as spiritual direction minister. Marcy, servant of God, we invite you to join us in acceptance of the call to this commissioned ministry. The United Church of Christ acknowledges as its sole head, Jesus Christ, Son of God and Savior. It acknowledges as kindred in Christ all who share in this confession. It looks to the Word of God in the Scriptures and to the presence and power of the Holy Spirit to prosper its creative and redemptive work in the world. It claims as its own the faith of the historic church expressed in the ancient creeds and reclaimed in the basic insights of the Protestant reformers. It affirms the responsibility of the church in each generation to make this faith its own in reality of worship, in honesty of thought and expression, and in purity of heart before God. In accordance with the teaching of our Lord and the practice prevailing among evangelical Christians, it recognizes two sacraments, baptism and Holy Communion. The United Church of Christ recognizes that God calls the whole church and every member to participate in and extend the ministry of Jesus Christ by witnessing to the gospel in church and society. The United Church of Christ seeks to undergird the ministry of its members by nurturing faith, calling forth gifts, and equipping members for Christian service. Commissioning is an act whereby the United Church of Christ, through an association in cooperation with the person and a local church of the United Church of Christ, recognizes and authorizes that member whom God has called for a specific church-related ministry, which is recognized by the association. By this act, the status of commissioned minister is conferred, an authorization granted to perform duties necessary to and for the specific ministry.
Hear these words from the Apostle Paul. At all times, make it your aim to do good to one another and to all people. Be joyful always, pray at all times, be thankful in all circumstances. This is what God wants of you in your life in Christ Jesus. Marcy, before God and this congregation, we ask you, are you persuaded that God has called you to the ministry of spiritual direction minister? And are you ready, with the help of God, to enter this ministry on behalf of the whole church and to serve faithfully according to the faith and order of the United Church of Christ?
I am.
With the church throughout the world, do you hear the word of God in the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments? And do you accept the word of God as the rule of Christian faith and practice?
I do.
Will you perform the duties of your commissioned ministry at Elm Street Congregational Church within the churches of the Central Association as one summoned by God to labor, giving God the glory and looking to God for strength?
I will, trusting in God's grace.
Members of the Elm Street Congregational Church, will you affirm your covenant with Marcy as a commissioned minister in your midst?
We receive you as a commissioned minister among us.
We promise to labor with you as your brother and sisters in Christ. We gather with you in the United Church of Christ as a sign of our mutual ministry in Christ's name.
Members of the Central Association, will you affirm your covenant with Elm Street Congregational Church and its newly commissioned member?
We, the members of the Central Association, Central Massachusetts Association of the United Church of Christ, gather with you, the people, and the one commissioned as a sign of our covenant and in celebration of our mutual ministry in Christ's name.
We are about to pray over Marcy's ministry, and I invite you to reach out whatever gesture of blessing you wish to bestow on her. Even though she cannot see you, she will fully feel the power of the Holy Spirit coming through each and every one of us. Let us pray. Almighty God, who out of your great love gathered one church by the power of the Holy Spirit to be the light of the world, we thank you for those in all ages who have given their lives to tend it, to care for it, to lead it, and to serve in every way to forward its ministry. Now we thank you especially for Marcy, who we commission in your name, for the ministry to which you have called her, that of spiritual direction. Guide, inspire, empower Marcy, and keep her faithful to your call, that by her life, your church will continue to be blessed and its mission brought closer to the fulfillment you intend. Through Jesus Christ, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith. Amen. Marcy, in the name of Jesus Christ and on behalf of the Central Massachusetts Association of the Southern New England Conference of the United Church of Christ, I declare that you are commissioned in the United Church of Christ to this magnificent and glorious ministry. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Let us hear it, even if we cannot literally hear it. Let us hear
each other. Thanks be to God.
Celebrating.
So I now have the fun tasks of presenting. So Marcy, we anticipate that your gifts to the churches, to God's people, will continue to grow and will have greater and greater impact over time. As part of our thanks for your sharing of your gifts, we offer this gift of a beautiful travel stole that you can wear in your hospice setting and at the church and when you meet with people. It still has Massachusetts, not the whole New England conference, but I think it will go beautifully with your red hair. Yes. May you feel the loving embrace of you and your ministry by this body every time you lay it on your shoulders. This will be sent along with a wonderful, fancy certificate of commissioning.
Yay.
Once Liz and I both sign off on it, that and the stole will be sent. And then it's been such a joy for me to work with you all these years. And so I have a little personal gift. I figured when you meet with people, you might be drinking coffee. And so I have this mug that says, I trust in God's unfailing love. A reminder of that. And I think, I don't know if others have anything that they want to present now or if they want to hit you up later.
I have a small gift from Marcy. It's the Holy Spirit in a necklace. I love it. I love it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So now for the charges. Kathy said so much that was so important in her speech and in reviewing everything. I was struck by how committed you were as you trained for spiritual direction to the interfaith aspect of the work, to setting aside your own credos or whatever, so that you could really be there to listen to people no matter what their faith beliefs were, or even if they didn't have any at all, that you found a way, you wanted to find a way to work with them. And I don't know if this translates well, but today I lost my phone and I had it on Do Not Disturb because I use it to watch the time in worship. So I couldn't call it. I didn't know what to do. I Googled, I found that there's an app that will help you locate your iPhone. And so I used the app, and I just had this thought, how easy it is to set aside Jesus sometimes when we get busy with things. But he's also the app. He is going to bring us back to ourselves. Jesus will bring you back to your grounding in faith. It's a deep well. You can pray, you can invite him to the beach, you can just pay attention to that relationship. That's my charge to you, Marcy, is to nurture that relationship with Jesus and to drink from the deep well of scripture that offers you insight into the way God works. I know you are in tune with the Holy Spirit very powerfully, but don't forget the other part of that Trinity. And I have a charge to the people, to not only Elm Street Congregational Church, but to the whole association. Marcy did not need to become commissioned to do a ministry of spiritual direction. That is not a requirement. But it was so meaningful to her. It was a call, clearly, to serve more than this church and these individuals. She has a vision. She has a call to serve the wider church. So my charge to you is to value this ministry, to pray for it, to utilize it, to contact Marcy and see how she can use her gifts to help not only you personally, but your church, your faith community. Compensate her for it when you can, because it's valuable work. Share the good news of what we have in this wonderful woman. Thank you. Next up, we have the anthem Amazing Grace by Liz Latondra.
Let us be in prayer together. Oh Lord, you know that Marcy has just signed up for one of the hardest jobs in the world. She has signed up to show other people what your love is like. And it's true, all of us as baptized Christians are supposed to do that. But Lord, Marcy has signed up to show us how you want us to love. May your Holy Spirit well up in her with an ever-growing stream. May you carry her through the hard times and the good times. May you show her ever greater depths of your love and help her to show that love to us. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Our closing hymn today, as chosen and so apropos for Marcy, is Here I Am, Lord. Please sing along.
Thank you.
Hello, everybody. There are just a few words that I want to say before the benediction in charge. I want all of you to know how special you are to me and how grateful I am that you are here. I know that I cannot see all of your faces, but I've felt your love, prayers, and support all day. I took the morning to contemplate everything that I wanted to say about my journey. It began 6 years since I started the process towards authorized ministry, but it began much earlier for me, when I knew I was called by God in a very new and different way. Some have called me pioneer and trailblazer. Truly, this new path has been laid out before me, was completely based on God's wisdom and calling. It took a lot of bravery and courage for me to stand forth and become a living prayer for my ministry. I'm excited to see how God will continue to expand the field and ministry of spiritual direction in my own church and in the churches of the association. I have always believed that the tenets and practice of spiritual direction can be used in new ways to open more windows to the soul and to help with discernment from the Spirit as to where we are going as a church, world, and people. Today, I promise to continue to use the gifts that God has given me to help you. Those that know me know that I have called this a celebration for all of us. This is our day. This is our time. It takes time and many steps to walk, to take a journey, but we do this together with love and connection to however you see the divine and connection to one another. My heart is welling with gratitude, and I just need to say to my friends and family, there were many times when I couldn't be present or was too busy, and yet you continued to understand and support me. My husband has been such a well of patience. I could not have done this without his love, listening ear, and guidance. You all have been my cheerleaders. To my pastor and church family, for living out the promises made at my baptism to love, support, and care for me, I promise to do the same for you and continue to do the same for you. To my Compassus family, for taking a hospice aide and turning her into a chaplain, thank you for hiring me as a spiritual director. This is uncommon in hospice, and yet you saw a gift in me and helped me to grow and flourish. Your support has been endless, and I love all of you very much. To my friends and community at the Spiritual Life Center, you taught me the sacredness of living an authentic, prayerful life, one where discernment and connection to God were key to my ministry and key to healing and to my own personal life. You have always held space for me and kept me in prayer. And to the Committee on Ministry, Doreen and Susie, my advisors, there were times when you challenged me to stretch and grow, taking into consideration as to what I needed and when. It helped me to face parts of myself and ministry that needed changing and more openness. When I first walked in, I asked you to do something different and beyond what was traditional. We all grew together in covenant with a sacred trust in God and in the calling. To my Mythical Journeys family, we may follow different faiths and paths, and yet I have found nothing but support from you. We carry the same banner and follow the love of law, acceptance, and inclusivity. I love you for this. It makes me happy that we can build bridges and work towards common goals to make this world a better place. And to all of the Elm Street pastors who have guided me along the journey in all different ways, I ask you to participate because you all hold a very dear place in my heart, and you always, always will. And you've taught me so many wonderful things. And of course, to my own spiritual director, I could not have journeyed in discernment without you. To Liz and Rick, thank you for being here with me today. I met Rick 7 years ago and told him of my calling to ministry. And today we come full circle. Thank you to Llewellyn, Jeff, Barbara, and Liz. I'm honored to have you here and for your participation. And now I leave you with a benediction And this is in the words of Teresa of Avila. May today there be peace within. May you trust your highest power that you are exactly where you are meant to be. May you not forget the infinite possibilities that are born of faith. May you use those gifts that you have received and pass on the love that has been given to you. May you be content knowing that you are a child of God. Let this presence settle into your bones and allow your soul the freedom to sing and dance. It is there for each and every one of you. And then I leave you with this charge. Be a living prayer, following the highest law of love. Go forth and love your neighbor with an extravagant form of love and acceptance. Walk in the ways of Christ and be. Be the peace, be the love, be the unity, be the hope. Do this with the faith of knowing that God loves us all, connects to us all, and works in us all. And may God bless you and thank you for being here today. Amen.